This is called Neo McGilp, and what this is for is thinning out my paint to a consistency that I can work with it a little bit easier. It also helps the oil paint to dry a little bit quicker than it otherwise would. And this is linseed oil. I usually don't use too much of this, but during the ends, when the end of the painting, when you're having to paint more fat layers over the lean, you know, it's useful for that. Anyhow, what I'm going to do right now is do some highlights on Superman's face to make it pop in the way that it's popping in this this representation that Michael Turner did. It's for Superman. What I do when I'm painting is I'm continually layering one coat over another, so doing this once a week is kind of perfect for this sort of thing because it allows my layer to dry so that when I put something over it, it won't mix up and get all muddy. So that may or may not work. Actually, I could use a little more yellow, I think. So yeah, I'm layering light over dark. Just it starts out very flat with the flesh, kind of like what you see here by the hand. That this particular color here is just the very flat basic color that I laid down, and then as I continue, I'll keep changing the colors and layering one on top of the other to make shadows and highlights, and that gives it the dimensions that make it look more like a real comic hand, as far as comic hands look like real hands. I do reproductions of comic book covers, but at the same time, there's always things that I see that don't really make a whole lot of sense to me, like, in this instance, you know, Michael Turner's great, love him to death, did wonderful artwork, still does, I think. But this whole configuration he did on Wonder Woman's legs didn't make sense to me at all, so I changed it a little bit on my own. Tones on his face. I don't want to mess with it too much more. There does come a time when if you don't watch out, you'll start overthinking it and you'll overdo the paint. Okay. Right now, I'm going to just kind of crisp up some of the edges on his hair.